कैनवस कंट्रोल एरिया नेटवर्क बस सर नर्व सिस्टम ऑफ एनेबलिंग कम्युनिकेशन यू नो कैनवस हैज नोड्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंट्रोल नोड्स दैट कैन से दैट ईसीयू So in our body we have the communication for a nerve system. So similarly, that car or automotive vehicle they have CAN bus as a nerve system. This electronic control unit, you know, this is for modern car may have up to 70 ECU. The electronic control unit may be placed. So CAN frame, so standard CAN frame with 11 bits identifier, CAN 2.0A, the most car, most of the car are having CAN 2.0A. So the extended version 29 bit identifier frame, CAN 2.0B, that is identically except the longer ID. So this is they used to heavy vehicle, heavy duty vehicles. So CAN standard frame has two types. One is 11 bit, another one is 29 bit identifier. So the 11 bit identifier CAN 2.0A and 29 bit identifier you can say CAN 2.0B. That 2.0 that is mostly used to car used in car. And 2.0B that is mostly used in heavy duty vehicle. So now we are going to see what is standard frame, how the standard control area network CAN frame might be there. Here we are having 11 bit identifier frame. The starting the first bit having start of frame. And then 11 bit identifier, standard identifier, and 1 bit RTR and 6 bit control. Okay, RTR means remote transfer transmission request. And then standard CAN frame, that is a 0 to 64 bit data CAN transfer, standard CAN frame, and 16 bit CRC, cyclic redundancy check. And a 2 bit acknowledgement, 7 bit end of the frame. So what is starting of the frame? So it tells that the other node, the frame is introduced. Then ID is a frame identifier. If the ID they having lowest value, that means the higher priority. Then I highest value compared to other. Then they have lowest priority. So RTR remote transmission request. This is indicate where the whether the node send data are requested to dedicated data from another node. In control, so control it contains identifier extension bit IDE. That 11 bit contain 4 bit data length code DLC. It specify the length of the data byte to be transmitted 0 to 8. You know that controller can control the data bits at 0 to 8 byte only have to transfer up to 64 bit only can possible to transfer in CAN bus. So that data contain data byte in CRC cyclic redundancy check. So this is used to ensure data integrity. And finally acknowledgement. So acknowledgement start indicate if the node has acknowledged and received the data directly. And EOF end of the frame. Okay. So networking during transfer of data when using CANBUS. So CANBUS embedded system control system that you know that car having transmission control engine control anti-lock braking control controller design board and then transmission controller transmission. So wherever you know there is a device they want to control, there they can put it controller area CAN controller, control area network controller. So using that CAN controller, they will control that entire you know car or vehicle or anything. So just now we discussed about frame. That is the frame they are given again. If you see the defector, they put it as 0 to 64 data bit length port identifier. So these are the things we just now discussed. It has 1 Mbps multicast and multi-master auto retransmission of enormous data. That 120 ohms line impedance twisted pair CAN H and CAN L wire serial input output bus. So these are components are used in CANBUS. So most common standard that is SJE J1932O PD2. So this is the example for higher layer protocols. And JE J1939, the standard vehicle network, heavy duty vehicle, the truck bus, they are using this protocols. And OBD2, onboard diagnostics, ISO 15765, so self diagnostic and reporting capability of mechanic is used to identify the car issues. You know, without mechanic it is used to identify the repair where the car is repaired. That is used by OBD2. And CAN open, it widely in embedded control application that is used in industrial automation. Now that industrial robot arms that is used for making manufacturing domain, that CAN open is used. The CANBUS data is longer is available machine diagnostics and optimizing the protection. CAN FD, CANBUS with the flexible data rate. So an extension of classical CAN data link layer, it increases the payload from 8 to 64 byte. It allow higher data bit rate, depends upon the CAN transceiver. This enable increasing data intensity use cases like EVs. So what are the four benefits of CANBUS? Simple and low cost. Yes, you know there is no complex, so it is simple and low cost. So it reducing error and weight and wiring cost, and fully centralized. The CANBUS provide one point of entry, so all the network is enabling central diagnostics, and extremely robust system, robust towards electronic disturbances and electromagnetic interferences. So ideal of safety and critical application, and it is very efficient. CAN frames are prioritized by ID identifier. You know that is the low value that will be the first priority. The top priority data gets immediately bus access without causing interruption of the frames. Okay. And Thank you.